So welcome at this next lecture, which actually is the first lecture of the second half of the series, because we are already halfway. Yesterday we had a focus on mental networks and how different adaptation levels can be found and modeled. And we then had some literature about plasticity and metaplasticity that we followed and showed how it can be modeled, and you did it also quite well in the assignment. That's what I've seen from it. Today we'll move to social networks, and that was the main title of this lecture, but I will also add a little bit about the biological situation. That's the higher order adaptive processes. And they will have the social network case will have second order adaptation like yesterday. The other one from the biological area is from evolution. It has as many levels as my sweater has, so you will see later. So let's just check. This first part is also has a relation to your assignment today, because in the assignment is also bonding bihomophily. The issue, the focus. The difference is that in this lecture here, I will show how you can also do second order adaptation, and we didn't include that in this assignment. So in the assignment, you do only the first order part. So remember that the principle says that birds of a feather flock together. If you are more similar, then you will connect more. And we model it by considering a tipping point that below, when the difference, the similarity is expressed like the difference between two states, two state values that you have, for example, the extent to which you have a certain opinion. If that extent is a little bit the same, then you are similar. So that if the difference between the opinions is less than tau, then you increase the connection and you become more connected. And when it's less, it's more than the tau, then you will become less connected. So usually, and also in the assignment of today, the tipping point is constant, but here we consider also the tipping point as adaptive. So that's the second order adaptation that's in this example. So we have this second order principle. This one is, we have even two, this is one of them. That if you already have more and stronger connections than some norm that you see for yourself, then your tipping point will become lower. That means that you become more critical whether or not you will connect to somebody. And if you have less, if you have not much connections, then your tipping point will be higher in that sense that you will be less critical. So that's I didn't find this in the literature, but these things, I think they have some plausibility. Already maybe because of the time that you have for connections. So the other one, the second is concerning the speed. So the tipping point is changing, but also the speed. So this is almost the same, but now the speed, the adaptation speed is so how fast you are connecting to people. So this is just saying similarly as the previous one, if you are already occupied with many contacts, then you will not so fast change your connections. But if you have almost no contacts, maybe you are a bit faster in changing your connections. So these are two assumptions made, and again, in this case, I cannot justify them by literature, but let's just see what the model can do. So the notion of more and stronger connections can be described in multiple ways. You can just think about more connections, but you can also think about the average connection strength. And that's actually what I now do in the example, but you can just easily make variations of that if you want to vary on it. So let's consider a simple fraction of a network. So suppose there are two persons that connect, and also these two persons connect. then this is not a strange picture anymore, I hope. So this is the same picture as for Hebbian learning, even two upward from the two sides and then the downward to the target, to the destination of the arrow. That's just the same picture as for Hebbian learning, for it is for the homophily, the bonding by homophily. So that's level is already clear, I think. That's not so the only thing that's different, that we use different functions, combination functions for these states. I will come back to that. So we have these upward links to fill the combination functions, to give them the values, the input say, and then you will calculate it. So the second level, because we want to model these two second order principles, we need tipping points and we need speed factors. Well, speed factors is actually the same as we had yesterday in the mental network. There we also had the speed of the connection adaptation. That's exactly the same. But this case, I have only one arrow to it and not three like we had yesterday. But yeah, that's a choice you can make. So the tipping point is new. So now we also have second order self-model states for the tipping point. So this are also upward links to the tipping points, for example, and also for the age. So all these things have blue upward link and this red, pink, I should say, downward links, they do the special effect. So they take care for the execution of their value in the right place, in the right role. So that's very important that these values are used in the calculation, for example, here. They should be used in the right place for the right thing. So therefore, that's the role ID. It should have the right role. So this has the role of tipping point, and this has the role of speed factor. So that's therefore it's used here in the right for the right thing in the calculation. So that's the connectivity, say, of the second order self model. So this is the function for homophily. We already have seen that on Tuesday. So remember, this is calculating whether or not there should be a positive contribution or a negative contribution to your W, to your connection. And it is positive as this is small compared to that. And if it's negative, if this is big compared to the tipping point. Now, for the second order self-model, there are two new functions. You don't need to know them, but I will show them anyway and give a bit of explanation of them. So this is one, note that in the name of this one, SL homo, that means simple linear. They are also quadratic and not simple, then it's AL or AQ or whatever in the library, but this stands for simple linear. And also here we have a simple linear form for the tipping point. This form is almost the same as for the homophily function. We also have this and this here, but now it's applied to the T, the tipping point variable in this case. And here, what I do here is just calculate the average connection. These are the connections to different people that the person has, the other person, or the person itself, I should say. So this is how many connections, this is actually the average connection strength that you have. So if you only have very not so deep connections, then this will be a low number. If you have only very strong connections, it will be a high number. But as said, you can also have other functions here. You can leave out the k and just take the sum, for example, in a certain way, or take the logistic function of them, that you have a kind of curve and not the average. So these, there are different variations, but I, for this case, I used just at the moment, I just use this. So that's the one function, and so that's the average indeed. And the other function is actually the same type of format, but then you apply it to the speed, to the age. And also, again, this is the average, and that could be changed in other things as well. So these are the two functions that are used for the states at the second, in the second order self model at the second level, the third plane, I should say. And it's applied to an example social network like we had before. in 10 persons, like a group of persons here. And then the question is, how do relationships within this group develop? So now there is a thing here. This is just the matrix for this picture. So this exactly represents the same information as was in the picture that I had just shown. But then in the case that we use this as a not adaptive network, then we have values in the connection weight matrix, the MCW, then there are values. So now the first question is, and I think you may be better in answering it today after some exercising, what should I do to have an adaptive network that these connections between them change over time? So you can just ask or say anything now. There is no wrong answer, just make a guess even. What should I do to obtain an adaptive form of this network, like it is now static? So what should I change to make it adaptive?
You could, instead of having just the weights there within the matrix, you could change them by references to the other X.
Yeah, so therefore you have to change these by state names, by x with numbers. And that means we also need the numbers, the states themselves. So the first step is that, let me see if I skipped something. So I have to add state name, new state names. These become the states at in the first order self model. And you see, I was a bit ambitious here. There were 10 people and all connections are there. So I need 90 new states in the network. I actually did do this and also programmed it even before we had this software environment. So there were many, I did it even in Excel. It's also not even so efficient programming. So there were hundreds of columns that I had to deal with. So I would not advise you to do it in that way. But this is a good first step. Then we have introduced a lot of new state names, and then we can continue to the next step. This is the connectivity matrix for the later things. The new state, these are the new states. And we have more informative names like here. And then they have just connections, like they are just doing the homophily. So that's in fact also these things are the same as in the Hebbian learning case, just connections one to these W's. Of which the last one is to itself. So that's one part. And then of course we have to continue because we also want to have these tipping points and the speed factors adaptive, and then we need another 90 states for the tipping points and another 90 states for the speed. So finally we are at 280 states. We will not give you such assignments in the lecture, so in the course. So then that's the next step, and then we also, in this case, the connections are a bit easy. They are all one, the incoming connections for them. So that makes that the connection weight matrix is filled. Of course, it doesn't fit on the screen, therefore all these dots are in between. Then we have aggregation. In this case, there is a logistic for the base states. We have this homophily function for these, of course. And then here we have these new types of functions that I just have shown. So that's also a bit simple. And they have parameters. And now for the parameters, of course, we have to add the place where the roles are described. So by putting these state names at this place, you say they play the role of combination function parameter, and especially for the tipping point, and for these, with respect to these states. So that's, that defines the downward arrows, the pink downward arrows. And again, for these downward arrows, you don't include them in the MB matrix, because then you would have a kind of double role, and that's not the idea. So you only include it here. So these have their own parameters as well. This is the norm for the tipping point, and this is the norm for the speed. I chose them the same, I think, in most scenarios. So that's important here. We have the speed factors, and of course these speed factors are also adaptive and modeled by these. So therefore these names are there. So it's the same idea. This defines the role of these states. So this is a first simulation. This model gives very interesting pictures and funny pictures, I should say, if you do simulations. So this is a person who tries to imagine, this is person X1. I only give the picture of X1. All 10 have such a picture, but their pictures are different, of course. So this is a person X1 that tries to balance his or her number of contacts. You should see it like that. And the average contact strength is this pink line. And the norm is 0.6. And you see that in principle, he gets in the right direction. And that's not automatic, because you have to deal with 9 other people and they have their own processes going on. So you depend also on them. But this person is indeed able to do a certain balance, but it's not, you see that there's a lot, he had much too strong contacts here. So he had to reduce, and then he overreacted so that he didn't do any strong contact anymore, a very low contacts only, but then, yeah, so it jumps a little bit down and up and here again up. And then here there are only 3 contacts that are strong and the rest is low. I think even some contacts were lost. They are now just 0. On the ground here. So that's, well, you can say this person is, he manages at least to achieve his norm. This one, in this case, the previous case, let me see it, show you again. Sorry, it's a bit slow. The alpha is a modulation factor in the tipping point that can make the strength. So I had strength 0.1 here, and the norm was 0.6. In the next case, the strength, I really made an extreme strength, so instead of 0.1, 0.9, so 9 times stronger. Now this happens for our power person X1. So apparently he still is trying to be somewhere around this 0.6, and here, he is at that 0.6, but now suddenly there is a new process starting. And if you look well, you see one person, X5, that is maybe a kind of bipolar type of person or so, I don't know, because this person is very fluctuating in the connection. So X1 was a bit stable here, but now he is reacting probably on this person mainly. So that now he's a bit more unstable for a certain time. So that's another simulation. And this simulation looks a little bit less stable in the outcomes. It's not even clear whether there will be ever a balanced situation. Maybe it will go on like chaotic behavior forever. I wasn't able to find it out. So that's another variant of the simulation. Let me check more. So now I went for 0.4 and the alpha 0.4, the alpha in the middle a bit, and a bit higher than the 0.1 and less than the 0.9. And this is now 0.4. And here again we have the X1, the person X1. And now you see that, it stays here. It looks that there is a stable situation here, but it's not at 0.4, but it's even above 0.5. So that's the average. So that means that you cannot, in some cases, you may not reach your norm value. I have another thing shown about this. This is all persons with their averages, their average levels. And this average is for everybody 0.4, in fact. So everybody would try to reach this 0.4. And you see that the average over the whole group is a bit closer to 0.4. It's 0.43, actually. But for the different persons, not so much. So that shows a little bit what you can do with such social network models. So that's 0.4 level. And actually, at the end, you get a situation that the most contacts are all or nothing. That's if you do it a longer time. So these are just gradual connections, and these are connections after a longer time. Some are zero and some are one, or at least close to these values. Okay, is there any question about this previous case? Then otherwise, I will just go on to the biological case. Okay, the biological case. You remember maybe that I told you I was doing some Google Scholar search for higher order adaptation, like second order, third order, fourth order. And for third order, I only found less than a handful of options. And this was the most interesting one. That's from Fessler and some other people there from biology. And they have an interesting quote here. I've selected this quote from their paper. And if you see, there are quite different concepts in it. This quote relates in one paragraph things like disgust, pregnancy, immune defenses, and pathogens. And that may, at first sight, it may look a little bit strange. How do all these things relate to each other? And actually, it turns out that they can be related by considering them in at four different levels in a biological network model. So that's what I will show now. And these indications are already a bit indicated by them, because they were the ones using these second order and third order indications. So what can you do? There are four adaptation levels or adaptation orders, because I also consider the introduction of pathogens as an important step in evolution from the ecological side. So then I consider that also as a form of adaptation. So then you have, say, there is an environment where you can function, say, in a healthy way. And then at some point in time, pathogens develop. So then you get a bad health. But then in another stage of evolution, immune systems develop. So then you are protected against most of these pathogens. But then in further evolution, pregnancy is developed as a way to reproduce. And in pregnancy, there is a problem that you should allow some material from a strange person, not yourself at least, to be inside. And your immune system should not kill that. Otherwise, if there would not be any special arrangement, then the immune system would just kill things and you would never become pregnant. So therefore, pregnancy poses a problem. And then as a fourth order adaptation, there is a notion of disgust develops, so that you, there are two things. The immune system should be suppressed to allow this pregnancy that it can function. And then the disgust should compensate for that. That you stay away from strange influences as much as possible. But I will explain it in a bit more detail. So the general idea is that you have a well-functioning causal pathway for good health. I will model that by just one causal link between the environment and your health, to make it a bit simple. And then the first order adaptation, then you have these pathogens. They have causal pathway that sabotage in a certain way. They negatively affect your own causal pathway for the good health. So that's how it works. There is already a causal pathway from earlier phases in the evolution. And then there is a new causal pathway that tries to affect that causal pathway, so that this doesn't function anymore. Then as a second order adaptation, you have the internal defense system, the immune system, that has causal pathways that try to affect how the pathogens function, so their causal pathways. So you stack causal pathways on causal pathways where one higher level causal pathway tries to affect the lower level causal pathway. So that's the idea that's also can be applied to the third order and the fourth order, that these causal pathways are affecting each other. I will show how you can do that. So this is the general idea. I think you can also apply it to different other cases. There is some more literature about other case studies where also these ideas of orders of adaptation can be found. So if anyone is interested in this specific area, you can even choose it for your final assignment. So this is the general idea then. I will show then how it can be modeled by a number of self-model levels of this type of orders, fourth order. And by the way, in the book, often the notion of reification is used. In the lectures until now, I try to focus most of the time on the notion of self-model. That's exactly the same. But reification is for many people a bit strange word and not so common. And then maybe the word self-model is a bit easier to remember and to write about it. But you can just make them as equal. So if you read things in the book where this term is used, you think that's the same as self-model. So this is then the situation. We will have to build some self-models. So this is the normal functioning before all these things happen, like before pathogens were in the world. So this is the normal context environment, and then this is a causal pathway to get good health. The E1 is the good health representation. So I simplified it just a bit. Of course, this in general can also be modeled as a longer pathway with different steps. But for this model, let's keep it a bit simple. So that's one thing. And now pathogens develop. So these are the pathogens, they occur. Then they disturb this causal pathway. That means that they suppress the representation of this connection weight. That's how it's modeled here. So by this link, this becomes lower. So therefore your health is not good anymore. So then the immune system is developed, and that is again suppressing the causal connection, the causal pathway of the pathogen. So therefore it's making this lower. And making this lower will get less disturbance of this one. So it makes this more lower, I should say, not this, just this arrow. So therefore this can be higher again, because this is not so suppressing anymore. So that's how it works. We have step by step a new level. So this one addresses this connection. This connection is the causal pathway for the immune system, and the pregnancy facilities, they make that the immune system is functioning not completely anymore. So that suppresses these pathways of the immune system. And then finally, we have the disgust. Disgust is a pathway that makes that the immune system still can work better, because you add to the immune system actually a behavioral immune system, like the behavior is also part of your immune system by avoiding, like we have it now, we are in most things in isolation. That's behavioral change that helps our immune system. So that's also a way to have a better immune system. So that's the last one. So then we have indeed a five-level model with four adaptation orders. And well, let's see how it works. These are the adaptive connections, to be sure. The other one is not adaptive. Maybe we have to wait for another 100,000 years to see whether there's more evolution going on. But at least these are now adaptive, and then they have influence on the process. But before showing simulation, I will introduce a new combination function that's also in the library, actually. That's a kind of opposite of the identity function. It's not the value itself that you take, but just one minus. So if the value is low, you have a high value, and if the value is high, you get a low value. It works more or less the same as a negative link, but not completely the same. So in this case, this is easier to use. Therefore, I've chosen this one. You can just convert the values. You can just switch the value 0 and 1 more or less by this function. So that's what we do here. Let me show you how this is the role matrices, just to make the picture a bit complete. So these connection weights were adaptive, so therefore we have these states here as names for the connection weights. So that's all. In fact, a relatively simple model, simpler than the previous models that we saw. And this is just all only values, not this type of adaptation things. So this is the first simulation. Now I went for a simulation where there is the immune system develops, and here the pathogens develop. And let me see. That's the adaptation. So here you are, the red one is the health. So you are in good health here, that's initially. But then the pathogens come in, these are the purple ones. So then your health goes down. So this goes over many years. So in fact, it goes over different individuals, of course. So, but you have to see it like that, that later this, in the species, that type of individuals have this functioning. So that after this pathogens come in, then this is low. But then the immune system comes in here at this time. And then you see that it goes up again. So this is a positive story, and it ends well at the end. Then everybody is healthy. But then, of course, we have the next steps in the evolution. So then we have the pregnancy. And then you see that, yeah, because the immune system had to be suppressed to become pregnant, then your health will be less. What's even is not so good for the pregnancy as well. But anyway, so that's then the next step. And then finally, if we also have the disgust, then we this is the disgust. Now this is the pregnancy, I think. Let me see. Here, this is the pregnancy developing, and then this is the disgust. Yeah, so the time scale is also compressed now because this is a longer time scale. So these are faster, it looks like, but the numbers are still the same. So then, because of the disgust, you avoid dangerous things more, and therefore your health will be better again. So that's the whole story of this evolutionary analysis. Basically based on what the biologists write about it, but it shows that indeed you can simulate the type of process by the different adaptation levels. So that was chapter 8 and chapter 7 and chapter 6 that I've discussed today. Are there questions about this?